In this video, I will show you how you can use Power BI to not only connect your data, but also to clean, shape, and transform it before you bring it in. Keep watching. So we're going to go ahead and pull in data from another data source. And this one is kind of representing manual or offline data. And I see this scenario all the time that business users have to combine some systemic data with some other data source. It's either manual or their own department data set, which is not available in the system sources. Could be a third party, could be something they're pulling from the web. So we're going to go to get data again and click more. And this one is actually an Excel file, so we're gonna click connect. And SQL and temp, that's my budget file, that's one I have downloaded. And I'm gonna click open. Again, this represents a manual data source, and there's only one table. I can click on it to see a preview. I do want this table, but this time I'm not gonna click load because clearly this is a little messed up. I don't want this column one, column two. That's not how I wanna load this data, amongst other changes. So this time I'm going to click edit, right? Now, when you click edit, you would notice on the left that this is not the first query. The tables that we loaded earlier are also represented here, but they were just the default. I mean, they don't have much going on here. It just simply grabs the table from the database. But for budget, it kind of grabs a table from the database, but we know we need a lot more transformation. By the way, this is a new window, so this is a query editor. Notice how it's opened as a separate window from the Power BI desktop, but you can consider it a component of Power BI desktop. So let's go through the query editor interface quickly. Again, the ribbon up top, very, very easy to use. A lot of stuff, 95% of what I use is just by clicking buttons up on the ribbon. Over on the left, you have the queries pane. A lot of times you end up with quite a few queries in your data model, and this helps you kind of navigate, go across, and just quickly edit the query that you need to. So that's a query pane. I'm just gonna collapse it for now because we're gonna focus on the budget query. Over here, this is showing you how the data set is going to be loaded. Now, this does not pull in the complete data set. In our case, it just happens to be a very small data set, so you're actually seeing everything. But imagine you were connecting to a table which had a million rows. By no means it's gonna pull in a million rows and show them to you here. It shows you just a preview, just the top few hundred rows, I think, that it shows you here. So it shows you a preview of the data set and lets you work with that. And over on the right side are some of the most interesting elements. So sure, there's the query name. I can change that if I wanted to. There's also an all properties button. I can click that and I can perhaps specify more description. This is a great thing for documentation for yourself or somebody else who might step in your place. You notice there are some other options here. We're gonna come back and talk about these options later. For now, description is interesting, but really my favorite part is this applied steps. Oh boy, this is magical. Now, when you connect to an Excel sheet like this, what it does is it scans the columns and tries to make its best guess about the data type. Now, notice in our data set, let me show you the, all right, so this is the file that we're trying to load. And this is what I call a human-friendly file, right? It's got headers up there, it's got color coding, it's got subtotals, grand totals here, and the numbers are spread across on the columns. And this is fine. This is probably, well, at least in this scenario, we're pretending that this is actually manually maintained by a group, right? So they go through maybe a review cycle and they discuss the number, what it needs to be, and they come back and type it in, right? So it's maintained manually. So that's the file we're connecting to. And go back to Power BI Desktop. So we're trying to pull it in here, but clearly it needs some cleanup. So in this scenario, when you don't have the data starting up top, then often this automatic step that's added, change type, doesn't really help. So in most scenarios, what I do is just hit an X to delete that step, right? So this is very easy to work with. A lot of these have this gear icon, which you can use to, let's say, change that steps. In this case, I can point to a different location. Imagine if a file source moved, now it's found in this folder rather than that folder, you can quickly fix that. Or you can also just hit the X and delete that step. So change type, let's get rid of that, we'll worry about that later. And let's get started working on this data set. The first thing we're gonna do is remove these rows up top, these three rows. And they're not needed, so I'm just gonna click remove rows, remove top rows, and I'm gonna say three, remove three rows, hit okay. And notice what happened here. First of all, this step got recorded. Remove top rows, and of course that's reflected here as well. Three rows are gone. And the cool part is you can step back and forth through these steps. So you can go back, like, oh, this is how the data came in, and click, this is my next step. There's a textual description which tells me what happened here. Remove top rows, and boom, I can see in the data set that that's gone. Let's keep going, and as I'm going along, I want you to keep your eyes glued on this applied step. This is really, really cool. All right, great. So now what I want to do, I don't want this column 1, 2, 3 headers in there. Really, row 1, the first row, should be used as headers. Guess what? There is a button for that. Right here, use first row as headers. I'm going to click, and again, it's going to transform hit here and record that step over here. So use first row as headers. Boom, that's done. Again, you can replay it. Go back, click. This is what the changes happen. Let's remove the subtotals here. So I'm just going to click on the arrow, and this exposes a lot of options. For now, we're just going to say text filters does not contain total. Now, mind you that Power Query in general is case sensitive. So if I type in lowercase total, let's try that. Notice the subtotal rows and grand total. That doesn't do anything. I mean, it says filtered rows, but nothing happened here. So I'm going to delete that step and try it again. Text filters does not contain. And this time I'm going to use a right case total. And now those are gone. This is probably the first thing that caught me off guard, the case sensitivity. But once you're aware, I don't think you're gonna get in trouble. And of course, there are lots of functions and methods to get around it. If you don't want a case insensitive matching, you can do that. You can convert things all to uppercase or lowercase and then do the matching or things like that. So we'll make sure we'll cover that at a later point. So for now, you got filtered rows done, subtotals are gone. If we scroll all the way to the right, there's a grand total column, which we do not want, because again, we have the monthly totals, no need for the grand total. So we're gonna right click on it and just say remove. And by the way, the button is up here as well, remove column. So again, grand total is gone and it's recorded in here. Perfect. Now the next step is by far my favorite. Hey, keep watching more videos and keep learning Power BI. But if you did enjoy this video, I would love to hear from you. So leave a comment, like, subscribe, all the good stuff. Power on, my friends.